back in one of the squares in front. And as you can see, there's the fake David, there's Medusa and Jesus. And then we're going to explore the Uffizi Gallery. So inside there's so many famous paintings. Let's go and explore it. Come on. So now we're in the Uffizi Gallery, and it's absolutely beautiful. And here is some Roman, very old Roman art. And either side of us, so there, so if you go right to my right, there will be the Raphael and Michelangelo's works. That means it will be the Leonardo Da Vinci's. So, which one shall we go first? Let's just go to Leonardo Da Vinci's first. Now here's some real Leonardo Da Vinci paintings. He's very talented. So he has a teacher, of course, an art teacher, and his teacher painted half of the painting, and then Leonardo Da Vinci do the rest. And basically, his teacher did some of them, then did half of it, and pretty good. So, two, teamwork. Now here, isn't really what you can call Michelangelo's work, that Michelangelo painted. That Da Vinci. Why don't you say Michelangelo? So, Leonardo Da Vinci painted the floor, but then he didn't want to stop painting it, so he knows why. So, Leonardo Da Vinci didn't finish it, he put it, threw it away. Then when Leonardo Da Vinci was starting to get famous, they took it out, someone drew over it, so little sketches, but by Leonardo Da Vinci. But another guy painted over it, and it's nothing that it's nothing at all about Michelangelo. I mean Leonardo da Vinci. Why don't we say Michelangelo? Sorry, every time I say Michelangelo, it means Leonardo da Vinci. Okay. So basically, this is not painted by Leonardo da Vinci. Yes, Leonardo da Vinci is painted by another unknown guy. So this painting, he painted when he was 22, and he painted it all himself. Some of his rare works that he actually finished and painted himself. Like, painted the whole picture all by himself. Painted the whole picture. So, this isn't his best works that he painted himself. But all the other works doesn't mean he doesn't have good talent. Let's go to Michelangelo and Raphael's. Now I can say Michelangelo. And the big circle one right there is Raphael's either. In fact, it's Michelangelo's. This should be in the middle of the Renaissance period, because Michelangelo was one of the most famous artists in the Renaissance period. So this painting is pretty nice by Michelangelo himself. Now let's move down. Painted by Raphael, a painting. Is it Raffaello di Angelo Doni? idea is like a Raphael version of the Mona Lisa. It's not the real Mona Lisa. The real Mona Lisa is in Scotland. This is like another Raphael version of it. This is double-sided as well. Raphael version of Mona Lisa, and this one is a completely different picture. Let's say potatoes or stones or something. And here is also a completely different picture from the very famous painting. I think it's called Spring, and it's painted by Botticelli. So here, on your right, is the god of. It's the god of flowers. And the two people at right at the end, not including the wind of the god of wind. One that's floating through the trees. The two people right at the end is the same person. So once the god of wind gave whatever it was to it, she turned into the god of flowers. There's Venus, the main character in the center of the painting. Cupid is blindfolded and he's shooting an arrow at the three dancing girls, ladies. And the three dancing ladies. So they're dancing to celebrate the beginning of spring. Then on your very left, that's the god of knowledge. Total, there's 200 different species of flowers in this painting. Now that's a lot. That's basically all it is for Spring by Botticelli. Let's move on. Venus by Botticelli. So this story is about, obviously, the birth of Venus, and she emerged from the sea. And right now, she's on a shell. The god of wind is blowing her to shore, whilst another person, or is it the god of flowers, or beauty? Well, it's giving her clothes to wear, decorated flowers. So basically that's the theme of the painting. And look at all those details, it looks amazing. And this picture is like really elegant. Like, it's good to see. It's good to watch. And it was so amazing, like just walking through, suddenly saw this so famous painting. Venus by Uffizi Gallery. the paintings are before the Renaissance period. So as you can see, the faces are flat on 2D. Circle around the head. Maybe that one's clearer to see. This face, the circle around the head. And each one of them should have some sort of story. And this is my favourite painting. This one. This is painted by Giotto, and this one is painted by his teacher. That's why it's all the same topic. So they were in a competition, then Giotto, the student, won. Because his teacher's work is 2D, and it's in the circles around the head. Giotto's had the circle around the head, but at least it's 3D. It's 2D. Some of the clothing and the knees are 3D. Some of the, you can't see the nipples sticking out. So that's 3D, and that's really amazing. And the building stage seats thing that Mary uses. First invented the three-dimensional pictures. So, very good painting. That's my favourite one. The room's a bit smaller, and these people feel this beeping noise is kind of annoying. These people are still in two-dimensional, like 2D. Circles around his head. But I just realised that not everybody in paintings has the circles around his head. I think it might be because it's just an evil person might not have the circle around his head. Or the people, or the not like the random people at the background might not have it. All the paintings have a golden background. Look at these. And they used these, so they figured out the way the painting were put together. So they put them all together and space and the ones that's lost. And this is a pretty nice picture. So these should be some kind of the shepherds, Jesus and Mary, the angels. So, oh look, there's Jesus again. Dripping from the feet is, if you follow it down, it's a skull down there. It might be like symbols, yes? Put down in the comments below if you don't. And the angels are collecting its blood. Yeah. And if you were looking very closely at the works, the angels' wings are also really colourful like that. So now you've got a feeling of what it's like in place with pictures, with paintings before the Renaissance period. So, if you go here, I hope you enjoy. So now I'm going, and I'll see you next time.